father.
No.
He taught his disciples to pray to his father.
So he's the father as well.
Huh?
So he's the father as well.
Who?
He's God. So he's the father.
Did I say it? Why are you trying to put your word in my mouth?
Are you separating the father from the son?
What is it?
Are you separating now the father from the son? Or is it the
of course, father? Of course. When the word and the father.
So the son didn't create.
Word and the father.
So the son isn't the ultimate authority, the father is.
Sorry.
The father is the ultimate authority, not the son, right?
Think about this. Let me give you an analogy here.
The son was
think
given
about,
authority.
Think about my friend, water. Water, three is one. Water is three in one. Yes? If his creation can be three in one, why can't creator be three in one? Do you understand?
That's not how you debate.
Do you understand?
Just because water has three doesn't mean that God. Why is there a correlation?
So this is what God is teaching you, that if my creation can be three in one.
We got to a point now. God is the Father, the Son is the Son, right? And the Son prays to God, the Father, and the Father is the ultimate authority. Jesus is the Son in human form, and he came to the world to spread a message, right? And to be a prophet.
Why are you rejecting
the one that created
this phrase when Jesus said, I am Alpha and I am Omega? What does this mean?
Hundreds of years after Jesus
when
died,
Jesus said,
he started saying
when
that
Jesus
God,
said, when
he, was, Je- he never said
listen
he was
carefully, himself. Listen carefully. When Jesus said, I am Alpha and I am Omega, I am the beginning, I am the end. What does this mean?
What does that mean?
Do you understand?
Explain it to him.
Do you understand?
I don't think you know that.
Explain it to him.
The Alpha and Omega.
No. You don't understand.
Which means?
I recited a very verse from John. In the beginning was a word.
In spirit.
In the beginning was word.
In spirit. You know his soul, his spirit.
Why are you twisting?
I'm not twisting.
Why are you twisting?
You're trying to tell me that Jesus in
Bible flesh. Doesn't say.
Are you trying to tell me?
Bible doesn't say that.
Are you trying to tell me?
Bible doesn't say that.
No. Jesus had a beginning and an end in flesh, in his soul.
What is it?
Because it has to be in spirit. Are you telling me in flesh, Jesus was in the beginning and in the end?
What did I say?
The Alpha and Omega.
What did I say?
Always has
I
been.
Said Jesus has two natures. Divine nature.
What part of him is divine?
Divine nature and physical nature.
Okay, what part of him is divine?
When he became human,
his spirit, right?
He humbled himself and took a flesh like you and
God
me.
God had to do that. God
like you and me.
Yeah.
No. As a flesh, he will show you
how to live,
how to eat, how to walk, and how to talk. He is teaching everything. He is performing miracles everywhere. He is performing miracles. He is giving a sight to the blind. He is giving a tongue to mute people.
Who did?
He is giving a...
Who did?
What is it?
Who did? Jesus, the flesh or the soul?
I didn't understand.
No. It's Jesus.
Which part of him is the divine? The flesh or the soul?
What is it?
What part of Jesus is the divine? The flesh or the soul?
Spirit, soul.
The spirit is the divine nature. Then you establish the spirit is a created thing.
You are not listening.
So if God created the spirit,
you are not listening.
I said,
your spirit and my spirit, they are created beings.
The camera's got it. Listen.
Yeah, come on.
The camera's got everything.
Don't run.
What do you want to say?
Don't run. But Jesus' spirit is divine spirit. Jesus' spirit is a divine spirit. That's why I said Jesus have two natures, divine nature and a physical nature. No, when Jesus is in a physical nature, he will eat like you, he will speak like you, he will talk like you, he will sleep like you. But when he is in a divine nature, he will do miracles after miracles, miracles after miracles. And that's why Jesus over and over and over again said, I'm Alpha and I'm Omega. Jesus said, I'm the way and the truth and the life. So we all are heading for eternal life. Who will give us eternal life? Who will give us eternal life?
Only if you have salvation. Only if you
are. No. The Bible. Bible in John chapter 3 verse 16 says, "For God so loved the world." Not Muslim, not Christian.
So I don't have to be.
So God so loved the world that whoever believe on Him, believe on Jesus, will have eternal life.
So I don't have to be Christian to go heaven.
Huh?
I don't have to be Christian to go heaven.
You have to be a believer of Jesus Christ, who died on the cross and resurrected on the third day. That's what it means.
So if I don't believe He resurrected on the third day, if I don't believe He resurrected or died on the cross, I don't go heaven.
No.
So I have to believe that Jesus died.
Of course.
Your God wants me to believe that He died.
Yeah,
and
He died for you.
On the third day.
Yeah.
And if I don't believe that He died and rose on the third day,
that's right.
I'm gonna go hell.
Yes.
When I die.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Thank you. God bless.
That's the truth, uncle.
Sorry?
That's just truth. You don't believe it, that's it.
That's Sorry.
His choice. I mean, if you don't believe that,
yes.
That's his choice, isn't it?
Yeah. See, the Bible teaches us clearly
that
whoever will believe on the death and resurrection of Jesus, because the purpose of Jesus coming on the earth and living with us is this, that He is going to be our atoning sacrifice. So He fulfilled the entire prophecies which was mentioned in the Old Testament. That's why Jesus said, now it's finished. Jesus has completed the mission. And Jesus died on the cross and rose on the third day. And I invite my Muslim friend to come to Jesus and
to have
eternal life. Yes. This is what we are heading for.
That's the goal.
That's right. There. God bless you. God bless you, brother.
Good.
Thank you.